Hey guys, this is Angela Anderson, and I'm going to be showing you how to paint an elephant today. This is an acrylic painting tutorial. I'll be showing you step-by-step how to do it from start to finish. It's our Mother's Day special. So we've been wanting to paint this little baby elephant for a couple months now, and it keeps getting postponed. So today we're doing it. Got my husband Mark with me.
Hey everybody.
He's been in the chat during our live show today. So if you have questions while I'm painting, you can ask those and I'll try to answer them. Let's get started. Alrighty, so I'm going to be using a 12 by 12 inch canvas today. This is a Pro Series 12 ounce Dixie. 12 ounce just means it's a little bit thicker than your normal canvas. Cheaper canvases will come in about 8 ounce, so these are quite thick. Why? Got a bunch of little papers on there from the inside of that. Sorry. So anyhow, these are one of their nicer canvases. I really like these. A little bit thicker ones, but you could really use any size canvas you wanted to. The original reference photo is actually a little bit longer than it is wide, but I've kind of cropped off the top and bottom just a little bit on this one. Go over my brushes really quick. Welcome to our moms and kids who are watching today. I know at least one of our folks told me that she was going to be painting along with her mom, so yeah, I'm excited. I think hopefully I'll go a little bit slower today, hopefully, and make sure that you guys can keep up. I don't think this one's going to be particularly difficult. That's why I kind of labeled it the mommy and me. even if your mommy is a little bit older, like mine is, she's still your mommy, right? Doesn't matter how old you get. all right, so let's go over our brushes here. This is a 1/4 inch and 3/8 inch blender. Really, basically, what you're going to want is some sort of a stiff bristled brush. So it doesn't have to be these exact ones that I'm using, but we're going to be doing mostly dry brushing, which means we're going to be using kind of a stiffer bristled brush with a little bit less paint on it so that we can kind of skim across this dark canvas. It'll pick up just a little bit on the texture of the canvas, and that paint will kind of skim across and it'll give it that kind of wrinkly skin look that we're going for. So if you don't have these exact brushes, that's fine. Just use what you've got. But these are kind of like a stiff bristled blender here in different sizes. And then I've got my Aspen brushes. They're also kind of they're a synthetic hog bristle. So hog bristle brushes will have that white texture. Those will be perfectly fine to use. The only thing with the hog bristle brushes that you want to keep in mind is that you don't want to get them really wet or they'll get kind of floppy. So these ones, the synthetic ones, are nice because you can wet them and they don't have that issue. I'm just trying to find a hog bristle brush. I know I have one just to show you the difference. Oh, there it is. Okay. So there's a hog bristle, and this is the natural hog bristle, and it just, you know, when you get it wet, it'll get floppy. But if you use it dry, then you'll be fine. And those are super cheap. So anyhow, okay. 1/4 inch, or I'm sorry, number 6 Angle Bright here, and number 6 just regular Bright. That's kind of a flat brush. Bright is just shorter than flat, so flat would be out to here, and this one's a little bit shorter. Short filbert number 4 and a 2 round. So just, I'm not sure that I'll use all these brushes, but just in case. And then I also grabbed a bristle fan brush. Not sure if we'll use that either. And then you're going to want like something for the eyelashes. So just a small brush. I thought the fan brush might work for the eyelashes. That's why I grabbed it. But really, I probably want to just paint them in myself with a liner brush of some sort. So, all right. And like I said, don't stress out if you don't have exact brushes. Just use what you've got that's similar.
I just use yours.
You just use my brushes?
Yeah, I don't buy mine.
You also want some sort of a chalk or a charcoal pencil or graphite paper to transfer on your design, white graphite in this case. This one's the soluble graphite paper from Sorrel. So anyhow, all the materials that I'm using are listed in the description and are also available at blick.com. The link's down below, and also on Amazon in my acrylic painting supplies. So all right, going over colors, we got basic really simple colors today, carbon black. And these two are optional, burnt umber and ultramarine blue. We're going to make a gray with that. That is totally optional. If you do not have those colors, just use black and white and you'll be totally fine. So carbon black, burnt umber, ultramarine blue, unbleached titanium, titanium white, and zinc white. And this one is glazing medium. Again, if you do not have these other colors, just use white and black and you'll be fine. Just pay attention to the value. So how dark the color is that I'm putting on. Doesn't matter. You could do this in other colors. You could really do this in any number of colors. As long as you get those values right, the dark area is really dark and the light area is light, then you're fine to do, you know, go crazy with it and use whatever colors you want. So the colors are not as important as getting those values right, the dark and light.
Okay. Somebody asked if they don't have zinc white, mm-hmm. what could they use?
You can use just titanium white and some, if you have glazing medium or some sort of a matte medium or some sort of a medium that will thin down the paint, make it more transparent, that will help. The zinc white is nice because it's already transparent. Titanium white plus glazing medium will get something similar. It's not going to be exactly as transparent, but it'll be close. So the transparency has to do, I think, with the size of the particles, and you can't make the titanium white particles smaller. So you're just kind of spreading them out thinner, but they're still going to be the same size inside, you know. So the zinc white, I think, are just finer particles. They let more of the light through. So it's not going to be exactly the same, but it'll be fine. And I don't think I'm going to be using it a whole lot. I'm probably just going to be using it to dust over some of these areas once we get them painted, just to kind of add just a little bit of color. All right, so let's, first thing we want to do is, well, let's go and draw our elephant. So I've already done that on my canvas, but I'll show you how to do it on your own. I've got the reference photo here to kind of show you some of the, angles. Let me see, what pencil do I want to use? I guess I'll grab this one. All right.
Somebody's got a good question.
Okay.
They asked if the chalkboard paint is the same as black gesso.
No, I don't think so. Chalkboard, well, I think they probably react similar, but I think chalkboard paint is made to be a little bit more washable, like so that you can wipe it clean. And I would think gesso would be a little bit more porous. It's like grippier, you know, it's going to grip onto, it's gesso in general is just made to be like a primer, and it's made to make your, canvas a little bit more receptive to paint, so it kind of adds a little bit of grit almost to it, so that it the paint can grab in there and really absorb down into the canvas. And like a chalkboard paint, I would think would be maybe a little bit smoother, so that you could wipe it clean. That's what I mean. Yes, I don't know 100%, but that's what I would think. So just thinking about the properties of both, but I don't see why it would hurt, as long as you. If you are working with the black canvas, one thing I would say is that I would still paint it black. So even if you have a black gessoed canvas, I would still paint it black, because we're going to be adding black and adding black washes and different things onto here. It's not going to match the canvas. So your black, whatever black you're going to be using, will not match exactly to the gesso. So anywhere that you add black on top of that gesso, you'll be able to tell the difference, and it might kind of mess up the look. So I would just give it a whole coat of black, even though you're starting with the black canvas. It'll just help the whole thing too. Then you won't have to paint around again. It's just going to be easier in general. Okay, so let's paint our little baby elephant. So the first thing you notice is this big long line down the side. So that's going to kind of be the first thing I would sort of mark out here is, and this is cropped, obviously, a little bit shorter. Well, actually, on our square canvas, it's going to be kind of like right in here somewhere. But I'll go ahead and draw it on the longer canvas, and you just know that you're going to probably crop off that top. So if you measure here, it looks like it's not quite a third of the way over, but almost. So you just kind of find your third markers there and there, and then come in just a little bit and kind of do your leg in. And then back out just a little bit. And then there's going to be folds in the leg that happen, but we're not going to draw all that in. We'll do it while we're painting. Then there's another leg coming this way. So it cuts off about the bottom third there, if you kind of go across. So if you kind of just measure there, it's going to start about right here and come across like that. Okay. Then this side here is going to be a little bit pretty much. There's our thirds, right? So this knee is just a little bit on the inside of that third here, this leg. And so this one is coming up right here from it. And if we get kind of some of our main shapes in there, then we kind of know where to put our baby elephant face. So he's going to be like right in here, and you can see that it doesn't go all the way to the edge of this. So it's going to be kind of somewhere in here. And this is just kind of an, if you look here at the shape, if you cut it off right here, it's kind of an oval shape right here at the bottom. So we're just going to kind of do that oval shape right there. And then notice that it comes up like this. So at this end of it, I'm just going to come up and back out just a little bit. And you want that curve to be, so right about the halfway mark. There is where the eye is going to be, and also where that meets right here. So if I find my halfway mark, we're right about there. Come on. Okay, take that one out.
Do you want my 3-cent mechanical pencil?
No, good.
Okay.
Someone's just running out of. And let me see if I can get the eraser out without popping the whole thing off. Okay. Earlier, when I was drawing in my other video, the leads in here, and this thing popped all the way off and spilled the leads everywhere. It seems to happen almost every time I use this thing. Okay, don't do that. Okay.
That is awesome.
We're going to be finding those everywhere. Just shot everywhere when I did that. Okay. Well, shoot. I'm trying to push that eraser up. I should have just grabbed my eraser. Sorry, guys. This is really exciting. Here, I have lead all over. I'm going to be finding it on the floor everywhere.
I have this 5-cent mechanical pencil.
Mm-hmm.
Got here, if you want to use that.
It's fine.
I'm not
it's
having good. Issues with it.
Be quiet. Okay. So just kind of wanted to erase that. It really didn't matter all that much, but it was kind of getting in the way of our drawing. So there we go. So we have kind of the beginnings of our, let's try that again, of our elephant trunk, and the eye we know is going to be somewhere in here. Now, if you want to, you could kind of think about this, the head shape being kind of a triangle. It does kind of like right about where that bend happens right here. It does have this kind of triangle thing happening where the eye is just below that triangle there. So that can help. And that will be kind of where the mouth is and where this is going to be curving in. Also, you can see where this leg is coming up. There's a little bit right here. So it's right about there. Kind of follow this line up and it kind of curves in a little bit. That'll be kind of where you're going to see this turn here. And I'm not sure if it's the mouth in the way or the knee, you can't really tell, or the leg, you can't really tell. That there's something right here in the dark there. And then here's the top of the trunk. Remember, we did that oval shape. So we know it's kind of right in here. And the tip of it is going to make this little triangle shape like this. It's kind of a neat little shape like that. Then it's going to curve back around. We'll see a little bit of the underside of it like that. This is dark right there. Okay, then it's going to go almost straight. So I've made that a little bit thicker than it needs to be. It's pretty thin right here at the tip. It doesn't really widen out much right here where I'm doing it. Let me go to that there. Something like that. And then it comes out and turns pretty quickly. So somewhere in here. And then you can measure out the rest of your trunk and kind of make it go a little bit wider as it comes up and around. So it's going to be somewhere in here. Can you erase all this? Like that. Okay. Then the back side, we already kind of did that little triangle shape right here, right? So this is the back side of that. Then there's another triangle shape for the ear. So it kind of comes up this way and stacks this way. It kind of continues this line just a little bit outside the edge of this line right here and just wiggles all the way up and out that way. And then here it curves around and in, back out, and then does a kind of some folds right here. Okay. And what that line was, it wasn't supposed to be there. Okay. And then there's all these wrinkles in the head. They're going to be kind of following the shape of the head there. Might bring that down just a little bit. And then you're going to have the body. And the outfit come there. And there's another leg right here and a little bit of the knee kind of showing right here. So I'll drag off that over just a little bit. Kind of like that. Okay, so there's our baby. Then our eye, kind of get the placement right. We're going to want to do, if you kind of look at the angle here, right from the forehead down, and then if you go across, it's just a little bit in from where that the tip of the nose is, or the tip of the trunk right there. So it's a similar angle. It's maybe a little bit in a little bit. So we can start there and then go just a little bit in right here, and we'll know that this is kind of right up in line with that. Make sure you come in enough. I think this needs to be over just a little bit. Okay, so you're going to do kind of some eyelid, some wrinkles around the top, and then the actual eye itself, it's kind of a curved line like that, and then all this is going to be eyelashes, so it's got its eyes closed, so we're not seeing anything here, but probably what we're going to do is darken up this whole area right in there, and then do the eyelashes over the top. Then there's a really heavy wrinkle underneath there too, underneath the eyelid, and lots of wrinkles all the way around it. And then there's a darkened area right there. So that's our baby elephant basic drawing. I think this is the mouth and this is the leg here. I think I can see a little bit of it. There. Makes a little more sense to me. But you get the idea. So I have the traceable available. My Patreon page, if you're interested in that. And I also have the reference photo posted all over my social media, so you can check that out and use it to help you. All right, so let's get to painting. So I'm going to grab I want to start with the white. Sorry. I smushed off most of that. I've got a little bit of black on there. I'm going to grab my white, grab a good amount of it.
Just regular white?
Just regular white. I'm going to mix a light gray. And I just... I had a pretty decent amount of black on there, so. Not a lot, though. You could use a brush to mix, too, if you don't have a palette knife, that's fine. Just kind of know when you get done mixing it, you're going to want to kind of smush that brush down to get all that paint off of there as much as you can, and keep your paint in. When you mix a color, you want to make sure that you're keeping it in a smallest area possible, because that way it won't dry out real fast. The more you thin it out and smush it out in a long, you know, big area, then the quicker it'll dry out on you. I'm going to get a brush here and just use that to scoop that off of there.
And we got several people who are painting along.
Awesome. Yay.
Taylor and her nephew Connor are painting.
Yay. Hey, guys. Good deal. Well, good. You guys can let me know if I'm going too fast. So while we're working. So that'll give us a good working color gray there. I'm going to get a little bit more of the white and just mix what's on my palette here, knife, which is just that gray from this over here. I'm going to maybe scrape up a little bit of it and mix up another gray that's like a really light, almost white gray. Maybe a little bit more of that gray there. Usually I would start with the white and add just a teeny tiny bit of black, but I kind of started with black. Too much black. Kind of didn't think that through, so either way works. Okay, so there we've got like a really not really light gray. What we're trying to do is we're just going to make a few different versions of gray, and that way we can easily kind of grab it and work with it. So I'm going to grab up some of this gray here, like a pretty decent amount of it here, maybe a little bit more. Actually, I'm going to grab this white gray too. I've got a lot of this lighter gray. There, okay, so right there, and then grab up a pretty good amount of black, maybe a third of the black to two-thirds of that gray, the lighter grays. So, and we're making a darker version. And then grab up some of that, and grab up a pretty good amount of black this time. So maybe 50-50 or so of the lighter gray and the black. All right, so now we've got four different grays here. I might add just a little bit more of this white. I'm going to try to grab it where I don't get the black and mixed into it too much. Okay. And just keep kind of adding the lighter color until you get it to where you want it to be. You just want it to be pretty distinct differences in these, and try to get it as different as you can, you know. Like, don't have two that are really close together. And these are actually pretty close in value here. This one is going to be good, I think. And then I can always add black to it if I need it darker. And I can add white to that one on the end if I need it lighter. But this will give us a good base, four good base colors to kind of work with. Then if we want to, we can also mix up. I'm just going to go ahead and mix most of these right here. Let's mix them right together. And this will give us kind of a warmer gray, dark gray. If you use a little bit more brown, it'll be a little bit more brown. If you use a little bit more blue, it'll be more of a cool gray. So just depends on how much of each you have, and it really doesn't matter which. This, you can see how different it is, though. It's going to be a really pretty kind of addition. We'll just use it to kind of zhuzh up the colors here and there, just add a little bit extra different color. Okay, so let's get to painting. All right, so we've got all this on here, hopefully. And if you were painting along, you could use your charcoal pencil or a chalk piece of chalk to draw onto your canvas. Hopefully it's already painted black. I did mention that when we posted this yesterday. So hopefully I'll be painting along about that memo. I'm going to start with the number 6 Bright. I think that'll probably be our good basic brush to work with. And I'm going to start with kind of medium to dark gray here. So kind of get these and sort of mix them together. I can already tell I probably don't have enough of that color. And we'll see how it goes on here. I'm just going to kind of see how this color, yeah, I think that'll be good, shows up. All right, so I want to mark the edge of my leg here. And what I'm going to do is just kind of set my brush almost flat. So I've loaded it up. I mean, I don't have a whole lot of paint on there. And if you want to, you can wipe your brush free of a little bit more paint. And you're just going to barely touch it on there and skim it. I'm going right over my line, so I want to cover my line. I'm going to set that on there. I can do it this way too. And then wherever I want another kind of section of the leg, I can, you know, they've got the little wrinkles and things in there. Can wherever I'm going to set that brush down, it's going to be a little bit brighter, and then I can skip it around. Okay, let me get some of the darker black gray here. Over here, it's going to be darker, so get some of the medium to dark. I grabbed a little bit of that brown too. I'm going to use that over here. And the wrinkles kind of go across. I kind of didn't do a very good job here. But we're going to add black over the top of this. So it doesn't matter if you get these wrinkles just right. I'm just kind of trying to add a little bit of texture to this. It doesn't, right now, these first few layers are not going to matter all that much. Just trying to get a little bit of a color down on here. Getting a little bit of the medium color. But you can already see how it's kind of like sort of looking like that wrinkled texture on the elephant. That's kind of what we're going for. So just keep, don't get too bogged down on any one detail. I'm going to get some of the lighter color. I'm not right in here. It's pretty bright, so I'm going to get some of the brighter color. Again, very light touches. I'm barely touching this down. This will help kind of skim it and get that. I don't know if you can see that through the camera, but we're kind of letting some of that dark color peek through in places. Hey. That.
So, can I offer my condolences for those who got snow last night?
Oh my goodness, really?
Yeah. So there's people. In fact, Beth, who sent us this wonderful gift here, she got snow last night.
Oh my goodness.
So I'm sorry. It is sunny and 65 and gorgeous here.
Don't hate us because we've got good weather.
But we're bragging.
And we. Probably midsummer, we're going to be wishing we're wherever you are. Just going to be verbal here. Well, you're enjoying the beautiful weather, so it all comes around, back around. Okay, so there we go. I like it. I think it's working. Okay. So let's just go ahead and this area here, I'm just going to kind of skim lightly, and we're going to, what we'll do is go back later and add. I'm going to go in the direction of the skin folds as much as I can, and then know that we're going to just go back in and add some dark lines over the top of it. Okay. Just keep on going here. Mainly, I'm wanting to cover over my white lines, so make sure that all of these white lines that you did when you drew on your elephant, that you're covering all of them.
Can you go over the reason why you would want to paint your canvas black if it was already a black canvas?
Yes. So we're going to be going back over this with black. All of this area in here, we're going to glaze in with a black wash, a color. And if you're using a different black from your background from this color, they're not going to match. So just black gesso is not exactly black. It's kind of a gray. It's a dark. It's not true black like this. It's going to be a little bit more chalky. So it's not going to be as deep of a black. And it's going to show the difference when you add any black on top of it. You're going to be able to see the new black. This black has got a little bit of a sheen. This carbon black that I use, you can see it's got a little bit of a sheen. And the gesso will be a flat black. It'll be a matte black. And so it won't have any sheen. And so everywhere that you've got that paint over the top of the gesso, you're going to be able to see the difference. Really obvious. It's very, if you do it, you'll notice it right away. Okay. So right in here, let's get some of the darker color for this area in here. There's kind of some darker. Maybe get some of this black and use it on the corner of my brush here and just.
And we're not sponsored.
I don't want to do too much. What?
You'll say we're not sponsored by the color black, so no, we're not paid to say no. That.
We get no. No loyalties. No, I don't have a paint sponsor. I wish I did. Spend a lot of money on paint every year. I have yet to find a paint company besides Golden that I like, and Golden doesn't sponsor artists, so unfortunately they don't have to. They're like, we know we're the best and we don't need to. I'm sure if they started, it would be like too many artists out there use their stuff. How do you choose?
Okay.
Speaking of sponsors, though, we do want to thank our brush and canvas sponsor, Frederickson. Yes. They're awesome. And I just got some new canvases from Fredericks, and we're going to be doing a giveaway this week. So next Tuesday, this Tuesday coming up, when we do the girl with the Impressionist girl painting with a redhead lady. It's the number 4 in our Impressionist women series that we've been doing. I love those. They've been really fun to do. And don't let the image fool you. We simplify everything a lot. So they are really easy. I've seen a ton of people painting them. They've been posting them in my groups, and they turn out really, really well. They're really fun and easy to do. So if you want to join us on Tuesday, we're going to be doing a giveaway. You don't have to be there to watch the video, though. You can comment later. I'm going to wipe that off. I got too much paint.
Sweet. So I can do something else?
Not you. Oh. But we're going to have a link where you can go to sign up to win the canvas. So
look.
Yeah. I don't know how you could, though. They're too big. They're huge.
They're small.
Okay. The canvases there are going to be the... I'm going to use this darker color down here. I'm trying to get the colors as close to the finished colors as possible. I went way too light right with this. So the canvases that we're giving away this week, we're going to have a giveaway on Instagram as well as the one on YouTube. So the Instagram one will be starting the same day as the YouTube one. So I'll have links to the Instagram, my Instagram page when we do that, and you can go and so you can enter as many times as you want. The one for YouTube will be through email, and then the one on Instagram you'll be just commenting directly on it on Instagram. But anyhow, there's these float canvases. The sides go tilt in. So when you hang them on the wall, they look like they're floating. They're pretty cool. But they're not this size. Oh no. They are 12 by 36, and you get three of them in the case. So they're side by side. You get a 36 by 36 inch canvas that's split into three parts. It's pretty amazing. Just bring past the camera. Yeah, here, you can run it past the camera. Here we go. What? And it's still going. And it's still going.
Oh, hit the TV.
Oh, hitting the TV, and there we go. That is the canvas. This, you know, three of those. That will be given away for every winner. So it's pretty cool. Pretty cool. And our patrons are going to be playing bingo with us on Thursday. And they're going to also, one of the winners are going to win during the bingo game. So we got a case for them. We got a case for YouTube. And we got two cases plus two friends on Instagram. So Instagram is the place to for sure vote or for sure enter, because you can win a case for yourself and for a friend. So, and we're going to have two winners on Instagram. So anyhow, pretty cool.
I got to go and get a friend now.
Tag a friend on Instagram. All right, here we go. So there's that. And then by the time we get down here, you can see it's very dark. So you're not really seeing a whole lot. So I'm using this darker color. And I'm just going to, the lines are going this way. So I'm just going to do my lines in that direction.
So all the information for bingo.
And I'm skimming all of this, skimming it.
On Thursday, is that available on Patreon? Or
it'll be posted on Monday.
On Monday, okay.
On Monday, we'll be sending out bingo card information.
All the deets.
Yep. I didn't want to do it too far ahead of time because I know me, I would lose that email. And if you're like me, if I do it too far ahead, I'm like, where did I put it? So we're not sending them out until the week of. And then that way, you know, we'll have it all.
Okay, good. We try to miss it.
And if you're not going to be able to play bingo with us, you can enter to join different. And we may play it more times because we've got a lot of prizes. We've got three sets of brushes, three sets of Strathmore notebooks from Princeton Scenting. And then I think the brushes are going to be these sets. There's a set of four of the Aspen that we're going to be giving away. So we'll have three sets of those. Plus three of the Strathmore notebooks that I just used to draw on these ones, the visual journals that I really like, because you can paint in them and draw with them. I would paint with them because they're mixed media. I use them to draw, but I'm pretty much, you don't need to waste the pages to do them.
Okay.
I'm going to get some more actually.
I'm going to hide the kitchen sink. Because you're just giving away everything.
Frederick sent us some really fun stuff. I can't show the stickers because they're a little bit inappropriate, but they say
we can put our finger
paint over epic. I know, they're really fun. Okay, so I'm going to use this lighter-ish gray to do this background area here. So this is all going to be light back here. So I'm just going to paint around my elephant. So you just want it lighter than this. I know. Yeah. So those are the don't. So those are the really funny stickers that Frederick sent us. There's four different kinds of stickers. So whoever wins the Frederick stuff will get stickers too. And then they sent water bottles. You didn't show the water bottles. Mark is more cracking up about the stickers. Yeah. So they gave us water bottles. So this is all for the bingo that we're going to be doing for our patrons. It's just a way to thank them for, so we got six of those and a bunch of other stickers and stuff. I've used these. They're pretty awesome. He was out of tote bags. I was trying to get some of the tote bags because they have some tote bags that say that same thing that's on the stickers, but they were out of them, so. Darn it. But he did send me a bunch of water bottles and kinds of fun stuff. So we've got.
And we will have available international and national, right?
Yes. All except for the canvases. The canvases are only U.S., unfortunately. But everything else is going to be international. So sadly, the Fredericks doesn't do the international shipping for the giveaways. It's just too expensive, I guess. But Princeton is said that they were fine with it. So, all right. So this one's a little bit darker gray right here. This little dude right there. And then right here. Let's go ahead. There's just a few places. And this is why I started with the black canvas, because there was really only a few places where we saw white. And even it wasn't a super bright white. So we can get away with just kind of putting this sort of gray in here. We may need a couple coats to cover it, but it'll be, it's a lot easier than painting everything else in gray. All right, let's paint this little part in yellow and with the white. Well, really not white, but gray. So anyhow, so yeah, we're looking forward to that. That'll be fun. If you're a patron, just be looking for that that email on Monday. In Patreon, we just have, you know, extra stuff that you can't get on YouTube. So got extra videos for the $5 level. And then we do a bonus video once a month. It's like a really detailed painting, all kinds of really fun stuff. And you can go to Crowdcast and see those, the ones that we did this last year. And then there's a bunch from years past too. Sure, if it's posted on, I have to see if Brennan posted it on Patreon or not, but we've got a bunch of bonus videos and challenge images that we've painted. The challenge images are the $10 level, folks, because those are even harder things and more challenging. Last month we did a glass jars painting that took me about 10 hours, I think. Something like that.
That last segment was 5.5 hours.
Yeah, I think before that it had been about 5 hours. I'd done maybe about 4 hours. So it's probably about 9.5 hours. Yeah, that's the one. So that's the $10 level that we did that one in. So, and they also get a Facebook group, and they also get to vote on what we do in our videos here on YouTube and for the bonus videos. So they really get a lot of input on what I paint in the coming, you know, in the following months. Sometimes I throw something in there that they didn't vote on or that I just want to paint, and I don't care what, you know, if that got popular or not, I want to paint it. That doesn't happen very often though. Most of the time I listen to those ladies because they kind of listen to the group, you know. Sometimes there's things that I just want to do, so I'll do it, but not very often. Most of the time I appreciate them giving me input. It's really invaluable. Helps me decide if I'm on the right track or not, you know, with certain things. Sometimes I'll see an image and I'm like, yes, I want to paint that. That's going to be awesome. And then everybody's like, nope. So, and then it makes me rethink. I'm like, okay, well, do I really want to do that or do I not? Okay, so let's do one more layer on this one. This one's a little bit darker than what I did. I'm going to get a little bit of this darker color here. There we go. Make some of that lighter color in there. This is the second coat on here, so I can kind of cover it really well. Okay. Again, just making sure that this shows up against that leg. Just want it to be a little bit lighter. And the color on the leg. And I'm leaving my sides black, but you can decide whether you want to paint those in or not. I just prefer leaving my sides totally black. And I probably need to go back over there and touch them yet. Okay. this is all going to be dark. So I'm going to go ahead and put the black right here again. And then get a little bit of my, maybe get this brownish gray, a little bit of this dark gray that's got a little bit of the white in it, and just use that for the knee right there. And then just use, I have very little paint on my brush here, and so I'm just going to be using that to kind of just scrape off and kind of go in that bend with the knee there.
Somebody asked about the brushes. They would like to know, are the handles really long for any special reason?
It gives you a little bit more leverage depending on, you know, if you're using a larger canvas, it really is helpful to have these longer handles. If you're using an easel, then you can hold them back and, you know, kind of some artists will actually hold them this way. And it's supposed to be an easier on your wrist. I like to hold them like a pencil. That's just how I do it. But I do hold them a little bit farther back, and it gives you a little bit more leverage because you have this back here, so that you can kind of do some of these like flippy things, and it gives you a little bit more weight. It's kind of like that fulcrum, you know, pivot point, gives you a little bit of weight back here to be able to pivot and do these kind of flicking brush strokes that I do sometimes. If you have a shorter brush, it's not as easy to do that sometimes, and you have to hold it, you know, right on the end. You can still do it, but and also, like, if you're doing, like, with the impressionist ladies that we've been doing, I'll hold it way, way back when I'm doing my sketches, and then that way I'm getting very little pressure on the canvas, and I'm also, it's keeping me from getting my line too tight. So I can get like looser lines when I'm doing those kind of more impressionist type stuff. If you're holding it way down in here, you're going to get a much tighter line. You're holding it, you know, more of in a vice grip. But if you're holding it way out here like this, you can bounce it around and get like looser lines and kind of a little bit more free flowing lines. So it's just personal preference, though. It's not a, like, you have to have it, you know, that way. It's just kind of helpful. And mainly, like, with the Aspen, I think the Aspen do come in shorter brushes, but the 6100 series that I like to use, the white, these ones here, they don't come in shorter handles. So that's, you know, this is what you get. And they're bigger sizes. The longer handles tend to come in bigger sizes. So the shorter handles are usually for like smaller canvases and things like that. So. Okay. So doing right here, we're pulling up this way. I'm just kind of blurred out that line there. So I kind of went over my white just very lightly so that I got kind of a blurred line right there along that edge, like sort of soft and fuzzy. I can pull back. There are little hairs on the elephant. I don't think I'm going to get that fancy though. Okay, this is a little leg, he's so cute. And probably this actually is probably the backside of his leg right here. So if you want to, and this is all dark though, so I don't think we need to mess with that back there really. We can just make all this go back into the background. We're going to glaze all of that along the edges, so. This line is very, very dark, so it's really very faint, the difference between this and this. So your value is going to be real close together. So maybe get a little bit of the lighter color just so you can see it, but you want to just barely be able to see it. It's going to be real dark. And when I say be able to see it, you just want to be able to, you know, tell that one's in front just a little bit. Okay, and I'll pull this down just a little bit more. and just make sure that I'm covering up all my white lines. So if I still see my white lines, I want to go back and cover those up from my drawing. Okay. I'm going to get a little bit of the lighter color and just put a little bit more.
Is that the old watering can or the new one?
This is the old one.
Okay.
I still haven't gotten the new one. I'm not sending the old one back until I get the new one. It's just too rusty. I mean, I barely had it any time and it's already rusting everywhere. All up and underneath. It's like crazy. I'm like, no. I just decided, you know what? That's not okay. Like, I was going to live with it. And I was like, you know what? No, I'm going to live with that. That's not going to be okay. And it's going to get worse the longer I have it. So I'm just returning it. Okay. So let's get some of this darker. I'm going to use this brownish color, the brown gray that we mixed with the ultramarine and burnt umber. You can just use this darker, you know, just add a little bit, maybe a little bit of white to your black to get, if you don't have that mixture. Just adding a little bit of detail to the leg. Not much really showing up on there. Okay, now right along here, let's get some of this kind of medium dark color. We'll use it right along here. So it kind of comes this way, and then see that it's kind of curving down a little bit right here too, but there's a little bit of a highlight right there on that part of the baby's body. And if you do it light enough, you'll get kind of a soft fuzzy. You don't want to see the starting line. So if you have too much paint on your brush, what'll happen is you'll see a really harsh line where you start your line. So let me show you what that looks like. So if I get too much paint on my brush here, and I've got it loaded up too thick, what'll happen when I try to skim it is, let me see if I can get it in an area where you can see it. No, let me use darker. Yeah, I guess on the back, yeah, that'll work. Okay, so too much paint on my brush doing this. What'll happen is I'll get a really solid line right there to start with. If I have less paint on my brush and very light touch, what'll happen is I'll get a fuzzy line. And I can go back and forth over an area. And always kind of where I start will be a little bit of a line there. But if I'm really careful and like go back over it in this direction, I can kind of disappear that line a little bit. And it won't be as obvious. So, but if I have too much paint on my brush, there's really not going to be any way. And I'll get these super solid lines instead of these broken lines. And this is what we're going for on this. This is the dry brush look that we're going for the skin texture on the elephant, because it just kind of makes it look kind of wrinkly. Okay, so let's get a little bit of this lighter color. So just, you know, if you are tending to load up your brush too thick, just every now and then wipe it on your paper towel, and then you'll kind of keep it right. And know too that it may not go on right the first time. You may have to give it a couple of coats. Okay, so I'm going to put the light color there. Have not reloaded my brush, and I'm just going to kind of lightly, very lightly, go along that fold, add a little bit of, and I'm curving it just a little bit. So I'm getting a little bit of a fold there in the ear. And then let's skim down here. I'm going to use the corner of my brush to kind of touch down right there. And then like right here, there's another fold and barely touching. So I'm getting really light, soft fuzzies. Okay, let's get some of the medium color. And if you're scared to do it you know, too dark, you can start with a darker color and do it first with a darker color. Practice it a little bit. And then Mark had a real hard time with this when he was doing his swan. He was wanting to load up too thick. So it just kind of takes practice. So just kind of know. And it's okay. If you get it too thick, we can always fix it. We can go back over it with black. So if you do it too thick, don't, you know, that's not going to be a problem. You know, we can always, this is a really forgiving painting to do. That's why I chose it for kind of the mommy and me thing, because we can fix anything we need to fix with this. So just kind of doing these kind of textures along the ears. And every now and then, like where it kind of dips up like this, that's where you can say, okay, that there's a fold that's catching a little bit more light because it's raised up, right? It's raised up closer to us, so that's going to have a little bit more light. So anywhere where I'm seeing these little folds, these little wrinkles right here, I'm going to maybe add a little bit of a highlight on that ear. And then right in here, it's going to be a little bit darker so I can see it against my background. And I'm probably going too light with these, but we'll be glazing back over this a little bit with darker colors. So it's okay if you get it a little bit too bright right now. Okay, really light touches now. Barely using any paint on here. I've got very little paint, and I'm just very lightly skimming it on my canvas. It's working better on the canvas than it did on that paper. And the paper, it was kind of showing a little bit more obvious, but on the canvas, it's a little bit, got a different texture than the paper. The paper's super smooth, so it's going to show everything, you know. On the canvas, it's a little bit more subtle. Okay. Okay, and then up here, we're going to go a little bit more paint here. I'm going to pull this way along that fold that's right there on the ear. Cover up that line. And then right here, it's really dark, kind of bright folds that we're seeing. They kind of merge down here. That. How are we doing painting along? Am I going too fast?
I think they got the tracing just done now.
No, they're like, what did we miss? Well, the nice thing about this, you can always pause it and come back to it. All right, so there's a bunch of lines this way. So I'm going to just kind of do a highlight up this way. And if I use my brush this way, I can get kind of lines. See that? It's still scrubby, but they're a little bit more controlled. I'm going to end up doing this whole painting with this one brush. This rate, it's doing pretty good for me now, so I'm happy with it. I'm just going to stick with it. And you use whatever brush you're most comfortable with. So if you're having trouble with, you know, a brush, you know, try to switch it out. I would say brushes can make a painting a lot easier. You know, if you have a good brush, if you're having a really hard time with a painting, you know, sometimes it could be the brush you're using, so... That's why I do recommend getting nicer brushes. I always, for my beginners, I have a little demonstration in one of my in my Facebook group a couple years ago that I did just to kind of show. But you know, doing the same brush stroke with the same paint with three different brushes and showing the difference between the different brushes and how a really good brush makes it super easy to do certain things. And a cheaper brush that's losing hairs or, you know, just isn't as, the cheaper brushes just aren't as responsive is the word, I guess, the best word to use. They're not going to be as flexible. They're not going to hold as much paint. There's just a lot of things about a cheaper brush that makes the process a little bit more difficult. And if you're a beginner, you want things to be as easy as possible because you're already kind of, you know, having to learn, you know, and so you don't want your brush causing you problems. Yeah. So I wouldn't go out and buy like a huge set of like the most expensive paints out there or brushes out there, but you know, get a decent brush. You will save you a whole lot of headaches. Their Select line is their cheaper line of brushes in the Princeton, and they're pretty decent. If you think this is something that you're going to be pursuing for a while though, and you know, like, hey, I'm serious about learning to paint. I've tried a few. I like it. And, you know, I'm looking to buy some brushes. I would just buy one or two at a time of the better brushes and just take really good care of them. Wash them out with soap and water every single time. Don't let the paint dry in there. Don't leave them in your water jar, and just take really good care of them. They'll last for years and you won't have to buy another set of brushes next year. You know, if you buy the cheap brushes, you're going to have to buy a new set every couple of years. And really in the long run, they're not saving you any money. So, and you're going to have a whole lot less fun painting with them, you know. Nobody that's bought the more expensive brushes have ever, like to me, at least come back and said, I really hate these brushes. You know, these are terrible. No, you're going to be like, oh my gosh, the difference is amazing. Trust me. So even just try one, you know, if you buy one brush, I would buy, let me show you the brush.
A toothbrush.
No. Well, okay. The toothbrush. And then if you buy a brush.
Here. Good hygiene is always important.
I'm talking paint brushes. Okay, so I should make this clear. If you buy one paint brush, Mark Anderson, I would buy that one right there, the 3/8 inch angle. So that one, you can do lines, you can do dots, you can do larger areas of filling in, you can do flowers, just about anything with that. And, trust me. And then you can see, you know, if you like it and go from there if you decide you want to add more. All right. So we're doing pretty good here. Hour in, we got most of our little baby elephant in. We just got the face. I kind of saved the face for last because it's going to be the most detailed part. So I'm going to switch to a little bit smaller brush now because I need a little bit more control. So I'm going to go ahead and grab the filbert. This is the short filbert number 4. And I'm going to get that kind of medium gray. So I don't know how I got talking about brushes. That I can talk about brushes all day long. Like, I'm very passionate about brushes. But I think it's partly because I've painted with bad brushes for so long. And I know, I know that how frustrating it can be, you know. Mm-hmm. We didn't have a lot of money when I started painting. So I've used a lot of bad products. I've been there, done that, learned my lessons on some things the hard way. And just realized there's some things you don't want to skimp on. Good brushes are one of them. Okay, so going around, leaving a little bit darker areas in here that I'm seeing some, but I'm kind of going with the direction of the wrinkles, just like before. Just filling in very lightly, not a lot of paint. Got kind of this medium gray here in my brush. We'll be going over it with a lighter gray too, but this is just kind of our initial layer. Some areas like right in here and like right on the cheek are kind of more solid. So you can go in a little bit more solid with your color. And then as it comes out here, I'm going to get a little bit of the darker color. And use that. Too much paint. See how solid that line is? So I'm going to just blend back over that. What I can do when I blend back over it is it lifts off some of that paint. So it picks up some of that paint that was there. And it kind of sponges it off. I'm going to get some black. Go back over it this direction with black. See? So now toning it back down right there where I have too much paint. All can be fixed. Okay. So it fades pretty quickly into black right here. So there's not a whole lot of in here. Do a lot of the medium color and then let that black be all along that line there. I'm going to put a little bit of it up here. Thanks, I'm sorry.
This is a menu.
Okay, well, just notice that I left this part out here.
I'm having an uncanny
sense to know
when you're zooming in.
Zooming in that you go somewhere else.
Of course.
It's amazing.
Okay, so this ear is mostly kind of a medium dark gray. So I'm just going to kind of dust over this whole thing and try to kind of follow the lines that I'm seeing in the ear, but kind of just dust this whole area in with a little bit of color, because we're going to be going over this with some black, but I need that color underneath to give it some texture. This is a super fun technique. Once you kind of get the hang of it, you can do all kinds of stuff with it. Makes it really easy. I use it for flowers. I use it for tree bark. Just makes it really fun way to add a little texture. And already our leg looks pretty good there. I mean, we're going to add a little bit of shadowing, but we're not going to have to do a whole lot with that. I'm going to add a little bit more of the lighter color now. So I'm going to get that little white, wipe most of it off. I put a little bit down, wipe it off, and then just smush it out. Okay, grab a little bit on the tip, very tip of the brush. Tap it on there where I want it. Wipe my brush off. And then do back over and just kind of fill in the rest with that. Okay, a little bit on the tip. Right along the edge there. Wipe my brush off. And just pull it out. Okay, that gives us a highlight along that edge there that's a little bit brighter. Don't do this many sections at one time because you probably have a hard time. But I'm just gonna do a few. Okay, let's do a few down here. Super bright right in here. Everything else is kind of a little bit more muted. But once we get our darker shadows in there, we can go back in and add even more if we need to. So I'm going to add a little bit more of the brighter highlight right there. On the ear. A little bit right here. Anywhere that you do this, it's going to really pull that forward. So just kind of be real selective with where you put this really bright color, because that's going to draw the eye. maybe right here. Almost white. You can use white if you wanted to, but it's not quite pure white. Yeah, that pulls that forward, just that little bit of white. Okay. All right, let's do this on the little snout now, too. Right along that line, and I'm going to pull it in the direction that I'm seeing those ridges in the snout, so they kind of, and that edge is kind of not straight, so using this curved tip is actually working really well, because it's getting like a little bumpy line there. That's great. That's exactly what I want. Okay, pull this direction, and then where they meet, I can use the edge of my brush and just do like little lines back and forth. Like that. Okay. This bottom area is going to be darker, so I'm going to do that later. And I'm going to continue these lines and use the side of my brush now and go. This is darker on these ones, but the lighter color kind of scoots around here like this. Right down the middle of this trunk. Back and forth. I'm gonna get a soft line on either side. I do it that way. Not too much paint on my brush. Back and forth. I'm going to use this along this edge, maybe get a little bit of the like medium dark, a little bit darker color. Do it this way with that. It's okay if the lines don't meet up, it'll all kind of make sense. We can go back in with the dark and separate out certain areas if we want to. Let me get darker and darker as I get closer to this edge here. This really should be a little bit darker. Get that gray. This is actually black right in there, but I'm going to go ahead and kind of pull it in, and then I'll darken it up later. This area right here, this is actually, I want a little tiny bit of it kind of showing through, so I'm going to go ahead and put it with this really dark black, brown black there, and then I'll fix it later. Cute. How are we doing? No more questions? Everybody's hanging in there?
No, but I have a drinking problem over here.
Spilling everywhere?
Yeah. I had a little piece of ice kind of jam up, and then it got water all over my face and my shirt.
Nice.
But I'll press on because I'm a professional. As they say, don't cry over spilled water.
You hanging in there?
Yep.
Good. All right, so I did the dark gray here, and I'm going to go over it with the kind of like medium gray, medium to light gray, let some of it show through. So no questions?
Nope.
Okay.
No questions.
Good deal.
Somebody had asked earlier, I just didn't get the opening then. I forgot. But they said that they had painted their canvas a gray.
Okay.
Instead. Is that all right?
Yeah, that's fine. Yeah.
Okay. So they were afraid they were going to lose some points. But there will be no points deducted.
I won't deduct points for that.
Okay. All right.
They'll just have to add the dark black in. You know, they'll probably end up leaving parts of this skirt, like parts of their background showing. And instead of doing this part, they're going to be doing the black over the top. And so they'll be painting in all these black areas. Same way, just different colors. But yeah, it'll be fine. It may be a little bit confusing, but I think they'll figure it out. Okay, so going out again with the lighter color there, just going to try to blend those in. Cute. Okay, and then let's do the same thing on this side. Let's get that kind of medium dark gray color. That in. I want to mainly cover up most of that black. That's what I want to do here. Only a tiny bit of that black kind of showing in between. The color's much softer. And then let's go ahead and use this darkest color, maybe some of that gray. Or in here too. This and this merge together. They're pretty close to the same color, so not a huge amount of difference right there where that comes up. But then like right in here, there's a little bit of this really bright color that starts to show up right there. Just in from that edge, just a little bit. Down from that eye here. And then leave this dark area right in here, kind of in the middle of the cheek. There's like a almost triangular area there that's kind of dark. And get the black. I'm just going to get that dark gray so it's not quite black. Go in this area right here. So in the eye area. Above. There. And then we'll go ahead and use it in the center too. And then right in here, there's kind of a crisscross. So it goes this way, and then it also is going this way. This way, and then you're also seeing lines this way. Lines this way and this way. And we'll go over these with the darker color when we glaze, and that'll help make more sense of these crisscrossing lines that we're seeing. And they're coming down the trunk a little bit right here. Getting the lighter color. Traumatic. No water bottle, the diva. It's always like trying to steal the show, making all kinds of noises. All right, middle gray kind of color here for the underside and Now you don't want like a black halo here, so I want to fuzz out that edge a little bit. Make sure it's good. And then right here in this dark area back here, some of this black, and just add a little bit of that over that line. I could see my chalk line, so I just need to cover it. And this area is actually pretty dark, so I'm going to use this dark black right in here. You need to warn me. Okay. My heart's going. I'm sure they didn't even hear it. They get your filter on?
No, I turned it off since there's no background sounds going right now.
Okay.
Our neighbor didn't get any of the rumbling in earlier.
We put our tomato, speaking of neighbors, we put our tomato starts out on the driveway. Because we had, I don't know, probably 20 maybe tomatoes that we just didn't have room to plant, you know. I think we grew like 3 of each variety that we were going to put out. And we put out about 12 different varieties of tomatoes-ish, something like that, 10, 12. There's 8. In the planters, 9, 10, 11, 11. And anyhow, they were gone. I was like, did Mark bring them in? Because, like, it was so funny that night. I mean, I don't know how long it took before they were gone, but they did not take very long. We put it up on the message board and stuck it out on our driveway.
And nobody said thank you or anything. They're just
disappeared. I don't even know who took them. Yeah. I wonder if like multiple people got them or if just one person grabbed all of them or what. No idea.
Since the boxes were gone, I would think that
one person just grabbed them. Yeah,
probably.
Well, good. And then I went to Lowe's and was like, man, that was like a lot of money worth of tomatoes.
About $60 worth of
tomatoes. Exactly. They're not cheap.
It's kind of like Halloween, you know, when the people just put candy out, the kids grab the first ones.
Yeah. Oh, well. No, I'm glad they grabbed it. I didn't expect them to go that fast. But they were kind of fun varieties, too. They were different varieties, so you can't get it. Look, we started them from seed, so. We're going to have a lot of tomatoes. Mark doesn't eat them. No. So I'll be the only one. I have no idea why we did that many, but I just couldn't decide which ones I wanted to do. So it's been a while since we've done a garden too. So this will be kind of our test. See which ones that seem to do well. And
Angela, in our
climate.
And Angela being Angela, she made me pull out the lettuce so she could plant her flowers.
Well, we had other places we could put the lettuce, but I wanted my flowers in the front.
Mm-hmm. just saying.
It's so perfectly logical to me.
If we go hungry, at least we have flowers.
Exactly. I think we're fine. All right. So just going through here, I'm just adding more layers to this, basically same places, just kind of looking to see where I may want to add. I think this is kind of the mouth area here, so there's some wrinkles right there where it comes down. It doesn't go all the way to the snout, the nose there, this trunk. I keep snout, nose, trunk. Check. It's like my kids. Spencer, Nathan, Jordan. It's Jordan. Not the cat. I used to call Spencer Scooter all the time when we had a dog. All the time. Poor Spencer. All right. So, yeah. basically you just kind of want to get it so that it looks like a kind of a gradual, you know, gradual change right here. This is probably the most tricky part and the part I would just take my time on, you know, just do as many layers as it takes to get it to where you like it. And maybe take a break halfway through, see what, you know, look at it, go get a drink, look at it again, you know, in new light. Sometimes when you get like right here, you just can't see what you need to change. So I'm taking a little bit of break and coming back and looking at it with fresh eyes can help sometimes. Mark likes that phrase. Or that's not the phrase. What is the phrase that you were teasing me about? I can't remember. No.
I like to have,
let it breathe.
Yes, let my eyes breathe.
That's right. I gotta let your eyes breathe every now and then. Okay. Oh, he's cute. So doing my line streaks this way through the... And then again this way. I'll just making sure that I've got my lines going in the right direction. And I'm doing them a little bit brighter than I know they're going to end up, because I'm going to darken all this up when we glaze. So go a little bit brighter than you think you need to. I'm going to go with my white here along the trunk. I want it brightest right along the middle there. Thin lines. And then they start fading out right about there. All right, cute. Let's do a little bit of a brighter highlight right here along the lid. There and there. Okay, and then let's use the... You could use the fan brush. Let's see if this works. Set it down, just scrape some little lashes. That worked just fine. See that? Set it down. If you thin out your paint just a little bit, it'll work a little bit better for you. Set my brush down and just scrape. Get my little lashes there. If I want to, I can go back in with a liner brush with my black and kind of separate out some of those. Maybe add some more with the white. There's kind of some on the bottom too. They have really long lashes though, so don't be stingy with them. And then right where they go up into the lid, you're going to want a dark line. So just make sure once you get your lashes on there that you go back in and make sure you've got a dark line right there where they're going in to the lid, the eyelid. Okay. Just kind of adding a little bit of texture along that lid line. Little dabs. Okay, now we're going to want to start glazing. So we've got everything kind of based in now. We've got all of our lines in and everything kind of the way we want it. And now the last thing we want to do is just do a little glazing. And that just kind of puts the finishing touches on it. You can leave it like this and it's fine, you know, the way it is. So if you like it, you can stop right here. If you want to go kind of like to the next level, we're going to get a little bit of black in our glaze medium here. You can use water if you don't have glazing medium. Just know that you don't want to add too much water. It helps if you have a fluid paint. So if you're going to do this and you don't have glazing medium, you might want to use, like, if you have a craft acrylic or an acrylic that's a little bit more fluid. So, because you want it to be thinned So you're going to have to add water. And then your craft acrylics, you can thin as much as you want because they're mostly binder. All right, so getting a little bit of the darker color. I'm going to use the bright, but you can use whatever brush you're comfortable with. Actually, I think I'm going to use the angle brush because I can get in and do some finer lines. It'll cover a bigger area too. So I'm going to use the 6 bright. So I've got this glaze here. And I'm going to just work on these wrinkles on the legs. So I'm going to kind of add in my wrinkles. The glaze will kind of make it a little bit softer looking, so not as harsh. And then wherever I want it really dark, I can go back in with a little bit of paint and add a little bit of that paint, maybe in the darkest areas. Just kind of using the tip of the brush, just kind of creating these little nooks and crannies in the leg. And then I'm going to use this dark color right along that edge. Just pull it in over the top of everything. Start at the edge and kind of work your way in. I'm just gonna tone everything just a little bit, kind of soften up the look. Use some that darker color for my wrinkles. Again, this is totally optional. If you're doing with this with kids, I probably wouldn't do the glazing part because it can be a little bit tricky. You could do these lines though with a stiff bristle brush. You go back in with your black and maybe add a little bit of water to it and use this to create. And I might switch to this because it gives like a little bit of a fuzzy texture to things. So it's kind of a nice, not as perfect, you know. Isn't that nice? It's working. Okay. If it gets too dark, you can just wipe it off. Wipe some of it off. You can always go back over this again with my light color. So this doesn't have to be the last thing we do. We can, in fact, I probably will go back in. So in some of these areas, once you glaze and kind of beef up those edges between the two sections, overlap a little bit, really bring that edge out. See that? Really fun. Let's stick with this brush. This is a 1/4-inch blender here. Glazing medium. The glazing medium just helps it to go on a little bit softer. That's all. It does. It just kind of helps it to be not so like super harsh. Everything's kind of soft and blendy here. And again, brighter right in here, darker as you go farther out. Mm.
kind of like us.
What?
Yeah, starting with you. It's kind brighter. Of bright right there and darker as you go out.
I love you. So funny.
Truth hurts.
All right. So the idea is to not really be able to tell where it, you know, where it stops. So just, you know, do this until you can kind of see, like, I mean, I want some stuff happening over here. So, you know, it shouldn't be completely black all the way to the edge, but it should, by the time we get here, you shouldn't see any more, you know, kind of like lines or anything like that. I'm doing the dark all the way through here. And we did the dark all the way along this edge already, so we've got some good darkness to work with there. Some of these lines come in sideways, kind of at an angle, so they're not all straight up and down. Just look at your reference photo and kind of see what you're seeing. There's not really any right or wrong way of doing this. They're all going to be, you know, every elephant's going to have a little bit of a different pattern on it. So it doesn't have to be exactly perfect. Just kind of have fun with it. Just make sure that these lines make sense. So, you know, I'm following these lines across and then doing my kind of basically similar kind of lines down. They don't have to all meet up, but it kind of helps if they sort of somewhat do, at least every now and then. All right, so there's that. Pretty happy with the ear overall. I'm going to maybe just glaze over it and just like I did before, get that dark black background canvas color. So this is where I was talking about that background canvas being different. This is where it'll really be noticeable. So just darkening up all of this along the edge. Using that glazing medium to help soften it up just a little bit. I don't want to cover everything. I want to just add just a thin layer of paint that's going to thin it out and kind of obscure my colors a little bit. And then I'm going to use that edge of my brush to do lines through it. See that? Adding these wrinkly lines here. Not everywhere, so don't have to do all of them, but I'm like right in here I want to have a pretty decent like definition right there, so I'm just going to use the tip and kind of pull from that dark area into where I want my shadows to happen. And this one got dark like around the middle and lighter, leave it just a little bit of the lighter color along the knee and along this outside edge.
If somebody's ordering through Blick, is there a special code or anything they need to use?
No, there's just a link down in the description of my video. If they go from that, it'll credit it to our associate.
Affiliate account,
yes, thank you.
Right, and there's no discount like at the Brush Guys?
No, but their prices are fairly similar, and they run discounts all the time, so you can use any of the discount codes that they have on their website, and it doesn't hurt anything. So they usually have, like, free shipping if you order a certain amount, or they'll have, like, 15% off if you spend $100 or more. So, you know, they're running different specials all the time. So you just have to kind of see what they're running. But their prices are always discounted. So their brushes are always I've never seen them at least be full price. They're always at some sort of a discount. And it's usually pretty decent discount. So it'll be comparable. And I would just check with the Brush Guys and check there and, you know, just look and see which one's cheaper. If, you know, if you're wanting the best deal, you know. Amazon tends to be a little bit more expensive just in general, but there's some things that you can get cheaper. You know, sometimes the sketch pads and things can be at a good price, but depends on who. It's not usually Amazon that's selling them. It's usually a third party that's selling them, and sometimes they mark it up quite a bit, you know. So it just depends on Amazon. You have to really kind of be careful. I don't buy art supplies from them very often. Every now and then, though. I got my gouache set from them, I think, recently. Gouache. I'm excited. I'm going to be painting outside this week. We got...
Gouache.
All right. So, again, kind of just shadowing down here. So, just kind of going over everything just a little bit. And then anywhere where I want to leave lines, just using a little bit more paint and just kind of going through with a little bit more paint and leaving like little lines through. And if I do too much, I can go back in and add more of my white color. So I might do that on some of these edges here. Grab a little bit of my highlight color and say, I want this to be a little bit brighter. Right there, covered up too much of it. Go back over it. And the more layers I find with acrylics, the better. It really... not the more, like, you in within reason. You don't want to like go thicker layers with your layers. I do thin layers, so I'm not laying down a ton of paint here. If you could do super thick layers, it can get kind of messy. Okay, so I just switched to this little smaller brush. You can get smaller details in here. There's some lines through here. And I'm going to definitely want to add a little bit of the light color right on that guy there. It's turning out pretty good. I like it. Honestly, not too hard. I, if you've been following along, hopefully you're not finding this particularly difficult. I think I really feel like it's not. It looks harder than it is. If you get your drawing right, you're going to be completely fine, because the drawing is most of what's going to make it look a little bit off. If you get your drawing off a little bit, it's kind of harder to make this work. But okay, I'm going to get a little bit of the highlight color and add it over here. And I'm gonna have to glaze back over that because that was a little bit light, but just felt like it needed a little bit right there. Pretty happy with the ear overall, I think. Might add a few little wrinkles in there. The glaze also just kind of unifies everything, sort of softens everything up a little bit, makes it look a little bit more realistic and just a little bit more unified. This is pretty much dry already. The nice thing about the dry brush technique too is it dries real fast, and so you can glaze back over it pretty quickly. Okay, so I'm there, just putting that in and then glazing back over it. And if I need the edges to kind of disappear a little bit more, I'll add a little bit more of the darker color, but I'm gonna go back into that wet paint. It's that black is wet still, so I'm gonna And this is also where we can start adding our zinc white. So this is our transparent white. So now that we've done our glazing, this will give us a much softer look than our titanium white will. It'll be just a little bit softer. And this would be, you know, if you don't have this, you can use the titanium white with your glazing medium. This just adds just that much more. And you can even add glazing medium to the zinc white to make it even more transparent. And maybe use it in some of our shadow areas where we want. To be a little bit lighter. I'm going to go back over that with a little bit of glaze. Just to blend that in. Okay, let's go ahead and use this, I guess, for our trunk too. So I'm going to go ahead and use the black glaze, and I am going to add just the slightest little bit of the zinc white to it. It'll soften up that black, make it more of a gray, but because that the white is transparent, it won't overpower the black so much. And wipe most of it off. I'm going to get a little bit of that glaze. A lot of glazing medium, a little bit of paint here. I'm going to go along that edge of my baby trunk here, elephant trunk, and pull in toward the middle and just kind of stop about halfway. Don't go all the way over the highlight area. If you get some on there, you can wipe it off. Okay. Darkening that up. Now, on the inside of the trunk, I want it dark. So I'm going to get the black this time. I'm going to go the opposite direction again. Get a little bit of glazing medium to help it blend in. I want it really dark in some areas, so in here, I'm going to use really dark black. If you get it over the top, that's fine. You can just wipe it off. Right here, there's a really dark, right where that comes out. Really dark section right there. Okay, and then all along here it's pretty dark too. I know I'm skipping around pretty fast here, but hopefully you're getting the idea. If you miss an area, you can always go back in and do it later. Keep on doing it until it gets to the darkness that you want it to be. You may not have to do much, you know, if you got your initial layers pretty dark. Okay, I'm going to go along this bottom side now and add a little bit more of that black glaze and darken up this outside edge of the baby. How are people doing painting along? Are they just too busy painting?
Yeah, they're not chatting. They're painting.
I know. I get it. I've tried painting along. It's not easy. I did it once with Cinnamon Cooney when we did a collaboration, and she painted mine and I painted hers. And oh my gosh, it's so hard to paint and listen, and you know, it's not easy. So that's one of the nice things about the videos, is you can pause them and kind of paint a little bit and pause it and, you know, watch a little bit more and then pause it, paint a little bit.
So when you do your other, they put it in French, planar, So I guess you, when you do your other painting, are you going to tape it with your new gouache?
Oh, I don't know. I don't. Film it.
Yeah.
I'm not sure.
I might have to do like a Facebook Live.
Yeah, it's probably going to be kind of more informal if we do it. It probably won't be on YouTube. It'll probably be on one of my social media, maybe Instagram or something like that. Instagram or Facebook. Got a pretty good community on Facebook in our Thankful Art group that we do chats every now and then. I used to do a weekly chat. I don't do it anymore, but a couple weeks ago I did one for the color chart that I had... I was just going to show people. So there's all kinds of art chats in there that I've done over the years. And then, of course, the one on for patrons, too. We do weekly chats in there now. Not on Facebook, though, on the Crowdcast. Okay, grabbing my white. I'm going to go over. Scritch through. I've got that dark. They're on now, and this is just going to be our last, like, little highlight on here, so. You can use this on our eyelid. Cheek a little bit. Find the raised areas and just go back over them and separate them out a little bit. Okay, and then on here, I forgot to do this on the trunk here. Got all of those little lines through. So we want to do the lines up from the outside up. Really emphasize those little wrinkles that are coming through. And then if you want to, you can use a thinner brush. This one's kind of, I'm going to press this as flat as I can get it so that I can get thinner lines. And do some lines this way through. Lightly scratching. And then take it and run some lines this way. Big folds right in here that you want to get.
I hope you don't paint me someday.
Why?
With all the wrinkles and folds.
Some big wrinkles here that we want to get.
Oh, there's a really big one over here. Let's highlight that.
Yeah. All about that play between the dark and the light. That's what gives it depth. And you can also, we haven't used any of this warmer white here. This is the titanium white. We can use that in a few places now too. So we want to go back through and add maybe just a little bit of the warmer white. Just gets a little bit different tone and, I don't know, adds a little extra something. You don't have to do it, but I feel like it kind of does add a little bit of warmth to it in places. So I'm going to figure out where maybe the light is kind of a medium quality light. You can add a little bit of this. Unbleached titanium in there. Maybe on the lead hair. It's a very subtle thing, but it kind of adds a little bit of warmth. And go back in with my black, my glaze, and I'm just fiddling here now. This is just all little, very little subtle changes. So you can kind of stop at any point where you're happy with yours.
So just want to remind everybody about the Patreon.
Yeah.
So we got, Angela, has different levels. The traceable is available at the $2 level and then $5 level.
Unlimited traceables.
Yes. Yes, that's a good qualifier. So you get access to all the traceables back to 2017, as many downloads as you want. $2. I don't think you can get a Starbucks coffee for $2. That's just one cup of coffee, not a whole month's worth.
True.
And then there's a $5 level, which you get that. Plus, you also get access to a bonus video that she does. A little is longer, mm-hmm. usually anywhere from 3 to 8 hours.
Let me show you the ones that we did last night for the bonus video.
Yeah. And you get reference photos.
All the old bonus videos too, not just the current month. So that's the one we did in May, in June. In when did we do this?
April.
April. What month is it? I don't even know what month it is. April. So May, we're going to be doing, what are we doing in May?
I don't know, some painting of some kind.
Oh, still life with an apple and glass jar and some fabric. So. Mm-hmm. Sorry, go ahead.
That's okay. You get the reference photo and...
I'm going to use this brush here, the number 2 round now.
And this stuff. And then the $10 level is all of that plus access to a special Facebook group where you can post all kinds of different things. There's another painting that's done over the 4-week period she showed earlier, the one right. she did last month. But yours. Again, you get access to all the previous month's videos too. So it's not right. just that month.
Right.
So. But wait, there's more. Act now. And we thank you very much to the over 2,500 supporters on Patreon.
It's you guys absolutely are so amazing to us. That's why we're doing the bingo to give. We contacted all of our sponsors and we're like, hey, we want to do a thank you party for our patrons. They've been awesome. They've been sticking with us through all of this craziness and the quarantine. I expected to be losing a bunch of patrons, and we've gained patrons through all this. So you guys have been just amazing to us. And I just, and our patron and our sponsors, Fredericks and Princeton, were very, very, very much on board. They're really, really awesome. And they were like, yep, absolutely. So they sent us all kinds of fun stuff, and we're going to be having a nice party with y'all, all the patrons, on Thursday night. And like I said, if you miss that, there's going to be other opportunities to win some stuff, but we'll have other giveaways going on for public too, not just our patrons. All right. I'm doing right here the little mouth area, like doing little curved, very small little curved lines here. I notice it kind of comes in right actually just below the trunk here. So kind of right in there, curving in. I kind of added some lines. This just kind of helps you give it a little bit more control. Kind of adding this white highlights along the edge of the trunk. Don't do too far in, because you don't want it to lose all your glazing, but then you can kind of stop and look at your reference photo and compare it to this and see, okay, you know, is there anywhere where I'm seeing a really bright area? So like if I look at my reference photo here, I'm seeing like a much brighter area on the cheek right here. So I think I'm just going to get a little bit bigger brush here, some of my kind of brighter highlight area, and bring this highlight down a little bit more. Brighten that up. Until I get it to where it looks kind of closer to what I'm seeing. And I can get my white to kind of add a little bit of really bright in there. There we go. Little apple on his cheek. I'm seeing some up here too. And it's not going to be like exactly, I'm not putting in all the little wrinkles and everything. So, you know, there's a lot of wrinkles that we've missed and things, but we're just kind of trying to get the essence of it. We're not trying to get it, you know, exactly spot on realistic. So I'm going to go through here with a few my glaze and just kind of glaze back those edges just a little bit. All right, I'm going to call that good. What do you think, Ken?
That's an odd name for an elephant, but okay. Good is his name.
Good is his name, yeah. I'm going to
put it's not like the farmer
right here, really dark. What?
The farmer had a dog and Bingo was his name, oh.
Yeah, we're going to be playing that.
Yeah, I know. That was going through my mind earlier. So there's an earworm for you.
No. No, la, la, la. I can't hear you. No. Okay. Yay. He's so cute.
What was his name, Mo?
Shush you. Okay, and get some of my medium dark here. I'm just going to add a little bit of highlight right there on the scene, like just a tiny bit right there. And this is where you can just kind of, like I said, kind of go through, look at your reference, see if there's any like little bits and bobs that maybe need a little bit of attention, a little bit more color you want to add in. He's super fun. I hope you try it. I hope you guys painted along with us. And hopefully I didn't go too fast for you. Oh, yes, we got a new new music. Oh, gosh. Gonna have to work on that.
Uh,
Who was it that sent that?
Beth.
Beth, yes, Beth Mulligan. Mulligan. Thank you. I couldn't think of the first name. Sent us the kalimba, is it?
Mm-hmm.
Let me see it. So she was like, in case Mark wants to use this instead of the cowbell. Apparently Beth is not a fan of the cowbell. That's actually really pretty, so it's not a bad idea. Thank you, Beth. Actually, Spencer had one already, so he was excited. He's probably going to confiscate it and use it along with his. Not that he can play two at a time, but I think this one's a little bit nicer than one he's got.
He plays better than I do.
Yeah, he actually can play tunes on his.
Yeah, we'll be sitting in the living room. Was like, what is that song? Mm-hmm. And he's in there playing on it.
Yeah.
Because he was in percussion in bands. So
yeah,
he played the xylophone and all that stuff.
He's got some talent. He can read music. Mm. Unlike us. Well, you probably could.
I got no talent. I can't read music.
Okay.
But anyways, but a shout out to Ruth. She gave, prior to us even going live, she had already donated, so thank you, Ruth. There was no special message there. And then the second one from Savannah, and she says, I love your videos. Aww. I've learned so much. I'm so glad that you walk people through each painting. Thank you, Angela. Mark, you're awesome, too.
Yay.
Oh, yeah, by the way.
He is awesome.
Hey,
you're
at least,
right.
At least you got my name right.
That's true. Get a lot of people calling him John.
Yep.
Ginger and Cinnamon both have Johns, yeah. That are their co-hosts, so Mark gets called John a lot. It's awesome.
That's okay. There are worse things I've been called.
It's by me.
True, true.
I love it. Okay, I'm just kind of playing now. Okay, I need to stop. This is one of those that I could keep on going and keep seeing new things for a while, but oh, super fun. I love it. I love it. Let me get a little smaller round brush here. I'm going to sign with my white, maybe with an off-white here. On this leg over here, since I've got more room. You need to add a lot of water when you're using a round brush to sign, and I'm choking up pretty tight on it and coming up about a quarter inch from the bottom edge so that if I do frame this, it will still show my signature. All right. Super cute. I hope you guys try this. This was super fun. Thanks for joining us for our Mother's Day special. Special shout out to all the moms out there, and especially those who are at home trying to teach their kids and work and all that stuff with all this craziness going on. Why, my heart goes out to you.
Putting up with their husbands that are working from home.
That's true. I don't know which one's worse, but no.
You can't homeschool them.
Yeah. Oh man, I would have gone berserk because never mind, I'm not gonna go into it, but Jordan especially was particularly difficult with my children trying to help with homework and stuff. I can't even imagine. Sorry, Jordan. I shouldn't have said that. They were all particular.
But if you try this video, hope you share it.
Yeah. Yes. Share it. Share it with us on social media. Let us know if you painted it. Take a picture with your loved one that you painted it with, and we'll probably be doing a blog post with those, so if you post it somewhere, we'll try to grab them all and post them on our blog. It'd be fun to see all of the families that painted these together. I'd love it. So all right, thanks guys, happy Mother's Day tomorrow, and give it a thumbs up, like, subscribe, all that good stuff. And we'll be back on Tuesday night, and we'll be doing a giveaway. So check for that.
Sweet. Tuesday.
Yep. We'll be painting our Impressionist girl, our third one, fourth one in the series. Shoulder. Uh-oh. I just dropped some canvases there. So there's our old one. So we're doing another one in this series that'll match up with this. So this time redhead, and we're going to continue it all year long. So we've got all kinds of fun new ones planned. So, all right. See you next time. Thanks for watching with us. Bye.